Ladies and gentlemen, here are today's lineup changes for the Calgary Inferno. Not dressed for Calgary today are number 12, Haley Irwin, number 21, Taryn Peacock, and number 4, Laura Gosseller. And today's lineup changes for the Brampton Thunder. Not dressed for the Thunder, number 67, Leah Whitaker, number 30, Sonia Vanderbleek, and number 24, Courtney Burchard.
If you think texting in the middle of a game is a bad idea, what about texting while driving? Don't even think about it.
Drive now, text later, live longer. A message from Insurance Bureau of Canada and the Canadian Women's Hockey League.
I've been in the league for 2 years now, and I've seen such a tremendous growth from the beginning, and I know that this can go so much further. So come watch this hockey. It's something that you're not going to see elsewhere other than the Olympics. And at the end of the day, those girls have to be in a league, and they play in the CWHL.
Fines. Just scores!
We live at a time when women are busy breaking barriers and building skills at an unprecedented rate. But the women of the CWHL are building skills faster and better than any other sports group in the world.
The accolades, and here we have a chance now to tie it up. Scores! Right there! Emmanuel Play!
The Canadian Women's Hockey League, the CWHL, doesn't just provide top-level hockey. It provides a place for those top athletes to go for all those years between those international competitions where they can continue to compete at the top level.
Having the opportunity to put a goal in and experience kind of a little bit of what the Flames experienced.
Oh, that got Cardell in the hand. Shot scores! Upstairs and over the shoulder.
I think it was that first time in my career, at least, that I realized it's going somewhere, and we're really solidifying the notion that this is a league worth following, it's a league worth growing, and the talent and everything that surrounds that is here.
Patch through Patch now. Patch leaves it for number 17. Shot scores!
You know, we're trying to better the league and try to, you know, grow it. And hopefully we can inspire a couple of young girls to, you know, play NCAA hockey or national level hockey and pave the way. You know, we're trying to pave the way for them. So hopefully we inspired a couple of them to pursue their dreams of becoming a great hockey player.
More trophy, but she comes down. Scores! Natalie Spooner! Toronto goes to the Clarkson Cup Final and faces Digit Murphy's Boston Blades!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome into the Century Gardens Arena in Brampton, Ontario, for our final regular season CWHL webcast as we present to you the Calgary Inferno and the Brampton Thunder live on SSN Canada and CWHL.ca. My name's Nico Cardarelli, doing the play-by-play of today's game. Steve Mitchell leading our fantastic crew as always. You see the captains there at center ice, Webster and LaRocque, for the ceremonial pregame drop, and we'll throw it down to ice level right now for the playing of O Canada and reset for puck drop. right, folks, let's get you set for this last regular season game between the Calgary Inferno and the Brampton Thunder. Brampton, well, their fate has been sealed already. They know they won't be qualifying for the Clarkson Cup this year, but still a lot to play for in terms of pride, and you can see some smiles on their faces there. The attitude of the group still very good. They're looking to finish the season on a high streak. They would like to snap a four-game losing streak. As I mentioned, spirits certainly good there between that group. And there's the opposition for today, the Calgary Inferno. Well, they know they're going to the Clarkson Cup. The question is, do they finish second or third? Montreal and Boston in action. We'll get to those scores in a little bit because that game could affect the standings. But Calgary, they've got a lot to play for here. It's Camille Troutman getting the start today for Calgary. She's got a record of 3-2-0 on the season, a .248 goals against average, and a .902 save percentage in six games this season. At the other end of the ice, it's Liz Knox making her 11th appearance this season, a record of 2-5-0-1, a .380 goals against average, an .891 save percentage, and one shutout on the season for Fort Knox. Just one player in today's game coming in with an active scoring streak, and that's Brittany Esposito of the Calgary Inferno. In her past two games, she's really been lighting it up. Two goals, two assists for 4 points. Calgary comes into today 14-6-3 on the season, 31 points right now, second in CWHL standings. As I mentioned, Brampton at the bottom of the table, 6-15-2 for 14 points. When you look at their goals for and goals against, eerily similar to last season in terms of the lack of consistent offense. Last year they finished the CWHL season with 43 goals for, but they've done a good job defensively this year, cutting down those goals against. Unfortunately, it wasn't quite enough down the stretch, and we're underway here in the first period between the Brampton Thunder and the Calgary Inferno. It's Brampton wearing the predominantly red jerseys, moving from right to left here. Calgary in their road whites, a little bit of yellow and red trim there, certainly similar to the Flames jerseys back in the day, and they're looking to continue their hot streak. As these two teams played last night, and it was Calgary with a 5-2 victory, and there they get the early chance as Knox turns that one away. Across center ice, Jess Jones hits the blue line, brings it to the near side hash marks where she's stripped of the puck. Good work defensively, and now Webster comes up with it for Calgary. They're pinned within their own zone for the time being as Davis plays it back to Wong. Webster from behind her own goal. Gets it to Sarah Davis, who had a big night last night. Get on those numbers in just a moment as Stone picks it up at center ice. Makes the pass to Davis. Scanzano with a good hustle gets to that loose puck and plays it around the far side boards where it's kept in by Esposito. Down low in the corner. Campbell back to the point. And Brampton clear the zone out to center ice, or Jess Jones can't come up with that one. Brittany Esposito on it first for the Inferno. Good job by Seedhouse to pick off that play. Really read the play well, and now Knox comes out of her net trying to help her defenders out. It's the skates of Fryer, so she's forced behind her own goal, or she plays it to Fortino. Fortino chips it off the glass and out. Gets it to Kirk, who makes the pass to Seedhouse. Seedhouse gains the zone. Near side hash marks. Dumps it to Kirk. Good D there as Cunningham all over Kirk. And then Kirk gives a bit of a slash to one of the Calgary players down low. That was Takuchi who ended up getting hit there from Calgary on a slash from Kirk. Johnston. She brings it in here. Rebecca Johnston back to the point. Under the stick of Cudmore, and Calgary will have to regroup as Schroeder picks it up. Brampton aggressive through the neutral zone, looking for turnovers, and Fortino comes up with it. Fortino, they have to hold the blue line. They can't. Offside there against Brampton. A good pace to this game, but so far it's pretty even through the first 2:21 of this game. Lindsay Vine on the draw here for Brampton. I mentioned the night that Sarah Davis had last night in the 5-2 win. Two goals and an assist for 3 points. continues to have a strong rookie season for the Inferno, now tallying 12 points on the campaign, and she'll certainly be looking to continue a good impact down the Clarkson Cup for them. LaRocque retrieves it, but it's icing against Calgary, so we'll retake the faceoff here inside the Inferno zone. Jenna Cunningham first on the puck, turns it over though, and Mallory Johnston, well, she'll fire it up the ice, and that's a turnover as well. Calgary looking to get something going. Here comes Danny Stone. Shot on, and that time Knox able to squeeze it for the faceoff. Good chance there from Stone, top of the far circle. She lets the wrister go, but Fort Knox equal to that task. Folks, we want to remind you that the Clarkson Cup is just days away, and you can still get some tickets for the games at the Cup as Knox turns another one away. For all ticket information, make sure you check out CWHL.ca. We want to see you in Markham, so make sure you come on out and support the growth of the game and the CWHL. Well, the Furies will have a chance to defend their Clarkson Cup title. Once again, they just squeak into the playoffs. Montreal, Calgary, and Boston, those will be your four teams contending for the Clarkson Cup title this year as Brampton bring that one in offside. Get a look at Jess Jones there for Brampton, their leading scorer. In 23 games played, she's put up 15 points, four power play points. That puts her 18th overall in CWHL scoring. Simmons at center ice gets it to Stiles, and she'll just fire that one in. Webster in the near corner. Fans on the first attempt, and Brampton won't put it behind the net, but Calgary quickly on it. The Inferno in front of their own bench, hacking away, and it comes out to Candace Stiles at the Brampton blue line. Stiles goes cross ice to Simmons. Pressured there, good job by Bearsons. And it causes a turnover as Campbell comes up with it. Jessica Campbell hits the blue line. Far circle. Face off dot. Jessica Campbell hits the blue line. But she's still got it. Far circle. Face off point. Takuchi, her shot.
But she's still got it.
A lot of traffic in front. The puck sitting there. Quick kick save that time.
A lot of traffic
by Liz Knox. Puck sitting there. Quick kick save
that time by Liz Knox.
Comes up with the puck.
He's
got Pierre at the point. Davis still holds it. Comes up back into the corner.
He's got Pierre at the point.
Unable to control it. That time was Esposito, but Campbell there for Calgary. They continue with the pressure.
Campbell there
back
for Calgary.
She kicks it to her stick. That shot, a good
back to
Pierre by Knox.
It to
her
stick.
That shot,
at least one bounce to the net.
Save by Knox.
It was a tough shot, and Knox was able to get the left pad on it.
It was a tough shot, and Knox.
Calgary starting to bring the pressure here as we play just about 5 minutes even in the first period.
As we play
scoreless right now between the Inferno and the Thunder.
Natasha Fryer to Fortino. Laura Fortino spins away from one, goes back to Fryer, makes the pass to Kirk across center ice. Kirk hits the blue line, shovels it towards the goal, or Troutman will just hold it. We'll get a faceoff coming inside the Calgary zone. Shot from Fryer from the point. They're sitting there, and that one on a second effort by Skuro goes just wide, but you've got a penalty coming here as Calgary probably called for tripping. Oh, now are they going to call too many skaters against Brampton? Scanzano jumped off the bench quickly before Noxie had gotten there. I think we might just get the initial call against Calgary. as it would be Tegan Schroeder heading to the box. So Branton will have a power play opportunity coming up. And there is some discussion here in terms of whether Brampton will be penalized. I don't think they are. In fact, they will have the power play. And Brampton, maybe a chance to respond here in terms of their power play. We want to welcome in Jeff Stevenson to the broadcast, who is doing double duty here. Stats for Calgary, but considering we're shorthanded here on the broadcast, he's going to be providing color commentary as well. So, Jeff, thank you so much for jumping in here on the fly.
No problem.
A chance here for Calgary to work on their PK. Maybe the one thing that they would like to improve before going into the Clarkson Cup, fourth in the CWHL, but they've already killed off more than 30 seconds in this Brampton power play. Wong rims it around the far side boards, hops over the stick of Scanzano, and Calgary with a bit of good luck on that bounce, clear the zone once again. Fortino hits center ice. Gets the blue line, takes a slash from Davis, and then she strips Fortino of the puck. Once again, Calgary's PK really efficient right now. Fortino gets that loose puck. Plays it to LaRocque. 50 seconds remaining in the Brampton power play. Jamie Lee Ratra hits the blue line with speed. She takes it down low into the near corner. She's got LaRocque at the point, plays it to LaRocque. Goes far side over to Fortino. Back to LaRocque. 39 seconds. There's a shot just wide. Troutman got the pad on it, and then Seedhouse, I think, was on the doorstep. Tried to jam it home. Troutman with a couple of good saves. 25 seconds left on the Brampton power play. They're starting to threaten, and just as they do, the puck clears the zone on a bit of an errant pass. Between some good penalty killing early on from Calgary and just weathering the storm in the last few moments, it looks like the Inferno will successfully kill off this penalty, just 5 seconds remaining in the Brampton power play. So a good start to the game for the Calgary PK. They generated some good chances prior to taking that penalty. Let's see if they can get back to the offensive play that they had before that. As there, they strip Jess Jones of the puck. Wong takes it, plays it behind her own goal. Quick return pass from Cudmore to Wong. They can't clear the zone, though. Simmons holds it in at the line. Plays it behind the goal where Wong, she's met by a check, and now Jones comes up with it. Jen Kirk, she's into the near corner where she's rubbed off the puck by Haley Cudmore, and now that'll give Calgary a chance to skate it out. Stone, she was hooked up a little bit, but she fights through it. Tees one up, and that one goes just wide. Good shot by Stone on that one. A little high and wide, though. She was looking for the top glove corner on Knox as we played 8.5 minutes here in the first period. There's a shot. Knox not taking any chances on that one. Gloves the point shot from Pieri, and that'll give us a stoppage in play.
Yeah, good pressure there by the Inferno after the penalty kill, but... I like what you saw from Brampton on the power play, at least getting a few chances out of there, if not really any great chances there, getting some momentum going.
Yeah, that's a good point. You know, the power play didn't necessarily start great for Brampton as Campbell shot off the draw. That one's blocked. But as it went on, they kind of stuck to what they were trying to get going. Eventually, it worked in terms of generating some chances, but between some good goaltending from Troutman and good penalty killing in front of her, Calgary able to kill it off, and now they're trying to get the first goal of the game here. We're still scoreless, not for a lack of trying. Both teams with some quality chances. Pieri makes the pass to the near boards. Stepping in off the side wall, and they're going to give it to Campbell, who plays it down low in the near corner. Player losing a glove out there. Play continues on as it was Sarah Davis, so she heads to the bench. And we've got Calgary heading to their first power play of the game as hooking the call coming up against the Brampton Thunder.
Calgary's power play has struggled as of late, but came a little bit alive yesterday, had some nice chances, and if it wasn't for some big saves by Erica Howe, it could have been a much more successful night on the power play for the Inferno, so looking to carry that over tonight for sure.
Hal was certainly busy last night, facing 43 shots, turning aside 38 of them in a 5-2 loss to the Calgary Inferno. And as Jeff alluded to, Calgary with some good chances, but they go 0-for-2 on the power play last night. So they'll look to change that here this afternoon, their first power play opportunity of this game. And Rebecca Johnston picks up that loose puck. She's at the point, makes the pass. Nice job that time by Rihanna Curio to get the puck down low. Campbell centers in front, and that one just wide of the cage. Good shooting chance there for Bailey Brand, but couldn't find the target. Johnston with a nice play to keep it in. Goes down low to Brand, looking for the return. Puts it back to the point. Long shot through traffic. That one's blocked by Seedhouse, and great work by Seedhouse to clear the zone.
Yeah, waited. Good job of getting the stick in the shooting lane by Seedhouse there.
Curio makes a move and makes the pass. Cunningham across the blue line. Far side hash marks. Elusive move. Delivers the pass to the zone, but Jess Jones there, and then that chance by Rebecca Johnston. Maybe off the outside of the cage. Looked like Knox was beat that time. Calgary still pressing. Long shot goes wide of the net. 55 seconds remaining here on the power play for Calgary. Sarah Davis, top of the near side circle, plays it down low. Return just over the stick of Davis. And now Jess Jones will skate it out. She makes a pass to Fortino. Fortino across the blue line. There's a shot right on. And Troutman in the butterfly position makes no mistake. She squeezes it for the draw.
Well, lots of chances by the Inferno early on the power play, but not a shot on net yet as everything gets blocked or going wide. So good job by Brampton to keep him to the outside and not give him those quality chances.
Yeah, absolutely. And Calgary was doing a good job with the puck movement, puck possession. You're right. The chances they had, though, mainly from the outside, are going wide of the cage. So if Brampton can keep that up, it'll certainly bode well for their PK. And there they get an icing call out of Calgary on the power play. So Brampton continue to be a bit of a pest right now.
Yeah, you don't see too many icings on a power play there, as the Inferno missing the stretch pass up on the left side there. And we'll come back and do the face-off down here again.
29 seconds remaining in the power play, 9:10 remaining in the period. We're still scoreless between the Brampton Thunder and the Calgary Inferno. You're watching live on CWHL.ca and SSNCanada.ca. It's the Inferno with the puck in their own zone. 15 seconds left on the power play. Maybe time for one last rush, but Brampton doing a good job to stop that attack, and now Scanzano will bring it out. So both teams 0-for-1 on the power play. Scanzano shot over top the goal, and we're back to five aside now. Here's Johnston, rejoins the play. Warren skates it in. Stopped at the blue line, but she gets the zone, and they fight for it along the near boards, where Brampton quickly get it out to Scanzano along the far side. Scanzano tried to dump it in, didn't get too far, and she peels off for a change. So Calgary and Brittany Esposito have a chance to break out. Esposito hits the blue line. He's got Bearsons. Makes the pass. Quick shot. Better glove save by Knox. And Jeff, that time it's solid fundamental goaltending for Liz Knox. When she starts with the glove high up, she makes it that much easier to make the save.
Yeah, definitely glove in the right position there, taking away part of the net. I mean, there's always something said for giving the shooter something to shoot at, but when you take it all away, it works out well.
Well, good save by Liz Knox, and Brampton are going to need more of that from her, and they're going to need more of this from Laura Fortino. She skates it. A potential coast-to-coast rush here, but she's rubbed off the puck. Great defense that time from Webster, and that'll put an end to the rush from Fortino. Puck still within the Calgary zone as Webster in the near corner down low. Makes the pass. It was just out of the reach of Crom, and that time Troutman had to deal with the clearing right in on her goal. That's Vine there for Brampton. She can't come up with the puck as Webster gets it for Calgary. Kelsey Webster hits the blue line and tries to get it in deep, but it was one against four. Webster trying to take on four Thunder players, and well, she did about as well as she could do given those numbers.
Must have been watching too much of Brittany Esposito doing one-on-four last night.
Esposito is such a sneaky player, Jeff. She's really tough to contain, isn't she?
Yeah, I mean, dynamic and full of skill, and just has those quick hands that you never really know what she's going to do with it as Calgary gets a penalty here.
Yeah, a little too aggressive on the check there. Scanzano into the corner with Takuchi, and It's going to be Calgary's Takuchi heading to the box for two or less. So Brampton going back to the power play, 0-1 in the game, 7-10 remaining in the first period.
Yeah, good chance for Brampton to take an early lead here if they can continue what they did on that first power play. Definitely want to work at getting those shots through the scoring zone of the net and get up high on Troutman.
Simmons and Mallory Johnston at the point, and it's Mallory Johnston who gets the puck. She makes the pass, it gets over to Simmons. Top of the circle, she lets a shot go off a skate and into the corner, where it's onto the stick of Jamie Lee Rattray. She plays it down low to Lindsey Vine, behind the net to Rattray. Rattray over to Vine, back to the point for Johnston. Far side, Vine steps in, far side faceoff circle, makes the pass to Rattray. Down low, now she's at the near side, centers it out front. Back to the point, Johnston shot, and that one's turned away by Troutman. Good blocker save there from Troutman. A great play by Calgary. Ooh, maybe Rebecca Johnston got a little too ahead of herself. Didn't clear the zone initially. Now she's got a shorthanded chance. Puts that one wide of the cage. Knox not taking any chances there. She'll just hold on to it for the draw.
Well, yeah, Johnston trying to get the quick break there. Yesterday they had a lot of chances on the power play coming off of those quick turnovers right at the blue line, so trying to go back to the well one too many times there and almost cost her, but able to get it out and get a chance.
Well, you got to do a lot to really hold Rebecca Johnston down, and even if it looks like she's lost the battle, you can't count her out of it. And that time when it looked like she was out of position and beat to make a play, she still puts a great effort forward and creates a shorthanded chance.
Yeah, now, most definitely.
And now Brampton on the power play, bring it in. Skuro, she's rubbed off the puck. 6:10 remaining in the period. 60 seconds left in the Brampton power play. Scanzano, far side hash marks. Fortino back to Scanzano. Quick pass to Mercer. Over to Skuro. LaRocque one-timer, and that one's turned away by Troutman. Brampton continue to generate good chances. Shots from the point. Fortino thought about teeing it up. She makes the pass to LaRocque. Back to Fortino. The one-timer in that one. A good stick save by Troutman. Puck up and out of play.
Well, you talk about going back to the basics for goaltending. I think that's the first thing they teach you is how to get that with your stick and deflect it over the glass to get that quick whistle when they're not going glove side on you. And Troutman doing that there to get the draw.
Yeah, she's really done a good job here this afternoon with her rebound control. And that was a great example there, deflecting the puck up and out of play as LaRocque has to retrieve this within her own zone. 27 seconds remaining in the Brampton power play. LaRocque nearly overskates it, but corrals it. Makes the pass to Fortino, who quickly gets it up. Scanzano across the blue line to Mercer. Back to Scanzano. Skuro there as well. LaRocque to Fortino. Fortino back to LaRocque. 5:20 in the period. That shot into the shin pads of Berzins. Puck stays in the Calgary zone, and Berzins couldn't clear the zone. Good fight, good chance, and Brampton keep it pinned in here. Fortino pinching in. Penalty now over to Cucci. Back out there, delayed offside against Brampton. Jeff Calgary hold on in the latter stages there, but Brampton continue to get good chances on the power play.
Yeah, I got three shots through on that one there, so lots of good scoring chances by Brampton.
Fortino's been a big reason why they've been able to generate those chances. She got it to Kirk, but then was stripped of the puck. The Inferno get it to center ice and out of the reach of Fortino. Cunningham has to hustle, but Seedhouse first back on it. Fortino, she's got it in the far corner. She's been out there for a little while. I'm sure she wants to get to the bench once Brampton clears the puck, but it's still on her stick. Laura Fortino stripped of the puck that time by Cunningham, and then she's nailed to the ice by Stiles. Seedhouse, they can't clear the zone on that one, and now they do as it comes out to center ice. Hag tries to evade Seedhouse, but all she does is end up turning it over. So here comes Stiles for Brampton. Stiles dumps that one wide of the goal. Takuchi first on it for Calgary. Tries to clear it off the boards, but it's kept in the zone by Skuro. O'Hanlon heading to the net, but that pass was a bit behind her. So here comes Rebecca Johnston. She hits the blue line. She's got an angle on fire. Oh, what a goal! Beautiful finish. Great move by Johnston, and that gives Calgary the 1-0 lead.
Wow, what can you say about that goal other than holy crap? it looked like she was running out of room there on Knox, had her pinned pretty well, and managed to delay just enough to get it around on the left side pad there on Knox there, and something that was just one for the highlight reels for sure there. And a nice job by Rihanna Curiel to get the puck up to her line mate there as well.
Yeah, good point, Jeff. Curiel making the initial play to end up getting it to Rebecca Johnston, and then from there she beat Fryer on the corner and made one heck of a move to get around Knox. So it's 1-0 for Calgary as we've got 3.5 minutes here. For the time being, Pierre's gotten credited with the assist for Rebecca Johnston. That's her 16th goal of the season as Calgary press for more. Knox coming up with a couple of big saves as Cudmore was banging away on the doorstep, and now Calgary will be penalized here as Fryer was dumped behind her own goal. So bit of a tough break there for Bailey Bram in the Calgary Inferno.
On the topic of Rebecca Johnston, of course, now that gives her 36 points on the year.
Yes.
A presumable safe cushion over the very dangerous Brianna Decker, who has come on strong in the end part of the season here, of course, playing against Montreal today.
And we'll get to that Montreal-Boston score in just a little bit to update you as we got another look at that highlight reel goal from Rebecca Johnston. Yes, 36 points on the season, as Jeff just mentioned. First in CWHL scoring. A big reason why Calgary have had such a successful season here. A great story in terms of, I wouldn't call it a turnaround from last year, because Calgary certainly had a great season last year too, making the Clarkson Cup, having a good run in the Clarkson Cup, but well, they've found a whole nother level here this season.
Yeah, blessed by a great rookie corps, and of course the trades getting Bram, Johnston, and Irwin to your team are going to make a big difference there. I'm sure if any team could add players of that caliber, they'd have a rebirth as well.
Yeah, no kidding. It was quite the offseason for the Inferno. It certainly translated to a tremendous regular season as they get set for their Clarkson Cup playoff drive. 107 left here in the Brampton power play as they're pinned within their own zone right now. Really good work there from Sarah Davis, and for all that hustle, she earns a faceoff inside Brampton territory.
Yeah, the thing that I've really liked about the Inferno coming on the last couple games here has been the emergence of this line with Sarah Davis, Brittany Esposito, and Jessica Campbell. Probably one of, if not the fastest line in the CWHL right now.
Tough to contain all that speed, and they're looking to generate offense right off the draw as Davis put one right in on goal. Knox used the paddle to turn it away. Now Brampton start the breakout of their own zone. Styles makes the pass to Rattray. Rattray gets around one. She's hauled down. Far end referee making the call, so it will be a penalty coming up. Brampton, well, they'll have a 5-on-3 power play. And there they maybe not intentionally give it to Calgary, but still worked out better that Calgary got it there, because, well, what, they'll have about 37 seconds here, 5-on-3 power play time.
Yeah, we'll see how the Brampton team can use this to advantage there, as Takuchi going off here for 2 minutes there, unhappy about it, but a chance for Calgary to see if they can kill it off and Brampton tie it up.
You know, Calgary's had such a fantastic season in terms of where they rank, pretty much in every stat across the CWHL, but I think the one thing Kevin Haller, Scott Reed would like to shore up before the Clarkson Cup is the penalty kill, as it just hasn't quite been as successful as I'm sure they would have hoped. Brampton looking to exploit that shot wide of the goal. Still 25 seconds of 5-on-3 here. Styles makes the pass. Simmons down low to Rattray. Sharp angle shot. Well, they're banging away. The puck was sitting there in the paint, but Brampton unable to capitalize. Net off the pegs there, so we've got a stoppage. Still 10 seconds left in the 5-on-3 advantage.
I know Rattray's got a hard shot, but was it hard enough to knock it off the net, the net off the pegs just that much there? Was that Troutman being a little sneaky there to get the break in the play?
Well, Troutman, you got to give her props if it was her move just to kind of help it off a little bit, but yeah, that scramble off the Rattray shot off the post. We've seen Rattray tee up a couple, but yeah, it's a good point. I'm not sure she's got that much strength in her shot, as we're going to have to retake this faceoff here.
Yeah, I know. We saw her scoring, of course, the two goals for Brampton last night, the one on the breakaway. She had been stumped against Bryan previously in the year in a couple breakaway attempts, so she was definitely due on that one.
Rattray, 13 points on the season for Brampton as they control it off the draw. Fortino back to Larocque. 2 seconds left in the 5-on-3. Bram back out there, but still a minute 20 of power play time. Backdoor play for Fortino gets shut by Troutman. Great save that time by Troutman as Fortino is sneaking in from the point. Scanzano to LaRocque. She thought about the shot, makes the pass to Fortino. Back to LaRocque.
Last 50
seconds here in the period. That one, Troutman with the active stick puts it into the corner once again. Good PK here from Calgary, and once again, the goaltender, a big part of it is Camille Troutman turning everything away so far. Just 33 seconds left in the period. Brampton looking for a late opportunity. Fortino makes the pass to LaRocque. LaRocque toes the blue line, goes cross ice. They get it back to LaRocque. Mercer got it to her. Skuro tries to get it to Mercer. Scanzano and Fortino dig away. It's behind the net. 15 seconds remaining in the near corner. Skuro centering pass. That one's picked off. Calgary will clear it, and that'll just about do it for the first period. Liz Knox trying to get her team up ice quickly here. Maybe time for one last shot. 2 seconds left. Rattray's got to let it go. Calgary right there defensively. Pretty good opening 20 minutes, though, to this game, Jeff. Good chances for both teams and a very tight game after the first period.
Yeah, it was a very back-and-forth action there. The power plays for Brampton controlling a lot of the play there. And a little bit of a discrepancy in the shots, as they just announced there, as had the shots 10-8 for the Inferno from what I had, but reversed down here. So who knows, I'm playing two roles here, so it might have been off a bit.
We'll definitely cut you some slack in your numbers. We certainly appreciate Jeff Stevenson jumping in to join us on the broadcast. You got to look at that replay, a beautiful goal by Rebecca Johnston. 36 points on the season now for Johnston. That's the difference in the game through 20 minutes. 1-0, the Calgary Inferno lead the Brampton Thunder. We'll be back with the second period coming up on CWHL.ca.
Texting in the middle of a game is a bad idea. What about texting while driving? Don't even think about it.
Drive now, text later, live longer. A message from Insurance Bureau of Canada and the Canadian Women's Hockey League.
I've been in the league for 2 years now, and I've seen such a tremendous growth from the beginning, and I know that this can go so much further. So come watch this hockey. It's something that you're not going to see elsewhere other than the Olympics. And at the end of the day, those girls have to be in a league, and they play in the CWHL.
We live at a time when women are busy breaking barriers and building skills at an unprecedented rate. But the women of the CWHL are building skills faster and better than any other sports group in the world.
The accolades, and here we have a chance now to tie it up. Scores! Right there!
The Canadian Women's Hockey League, the CWHL, doesn't just provide top-level hockey. It provides a place for those top athletes to go for all those years between those international competitions where they can continue to compete at the top level.
Having the opportunity to put a goal in and experience kind of a little bit of what the Flames experienced.
Oh, that got Cardell in the hand. Shot scores! Upstairs and over the shoulder.
I think it was that first time in my career, at least, that I realized it's going somewhere, and we're really solidifying the notion that this is a league worth following, it's a league worth growing, and the talent and everything that surrounds that is here.
Patch now. Patch leaves it for number 17. Shot scores!
You know, we're trying to better the league and try to, you know, grow it, and hopefully we can inspire a couple of young girls to, you know, play NCAA hockey or national level hockey and pave the way. You know, we're trying to pave the way for them. So hopefully we inspired a couple of them to pursue their dreams of becoming a great hockey player.
The Ward Trophy, here she comes now. Scores! Natalie Spooner! Toronto goes to the Clarkson Cup Final and faces Digit Murphy's Boston Blaze!
Well, we're back for the second period of play between the Calgary Inferno and the Brampton Thunder, and it was a very entertaining opening 20 minutes in this one. Great chances for both teams, but after 20 minutes, it's the Calgary Inferno with a 1-0 lead, courtesy a highlight reel goal from Rebecca Johnston. That was all the scoring in the first period. Both goaltenders were busy, both teams with great chances, but Jeff, after 20 minutes, Calgary with a slight lead right now.
Well, that's all it is right now. It's a slight lead. It's a one-goal game, and we know how quickly goals can get scored at as we get another chance to look at this goal by Rebecca Johnston here. I'll get my first chance to get a second look at it here. You just see the patience that she had there to hang on to it and give herself that opportunity to go back to the right side as Knox slid the opposite way and put Calgary up. So they've got to do a good job of building off that, putting the pressure on. It was a close game yesterday through two periods. It was
right.
Only the third period where Calgary, whether it was their endurance, their conditioning, or just their will to win or whatever the case was, they decided to turn it on another level, out shooting Brampton 20-3 in that third period there. So if Calgary can hang on to it, if they keep a one goal lead, a two goal lead, I like their options.
Mm-hmm.
Brampton needs a very strong period. They got to come out of this one with a lead to have a chance, I think, in my opinion, to win this game.
Yeah, it's a good point, Jeff. And you mentioned the game yesterday. You're right. It was very tight through 40, tied 2-2 after 40. And then Calgary opened it up in the third with three unanswered to get that 5-2 victory. Well, Calgary have continued to play well here, but they're going to start the second period shorthanded. Just 10 seconds remaining here in the Brampton power play. Right off the draw, Crom, she can't corral it, and Johnston, Mallory Johnston, has it for Brampton. Set to rejoin the play is Takuchi. She's out of the box, so we're back to 5-on-5. Well, we want to hear from you on social media. Let us know where you're tuning into the game, where you're catching the action from. You can tweet us. My Twitter handle is @BroBehindTheMic. You can, of course, tweet the CWHL at CWHL_insider as Danny Stone tries to cycle into the slot. Of course, both these teams have Twitter accounts as well, at Brampton CWHL, at Inferno CWHL. Jeff, are you on Twitter personally?
I am, WWO Jeff, J-E-F-F.
There you go. So you can give Jeff a follow as well. Tweet us. Let us know where you're catching the action from. We'll get to some shout-outs in a bit as Liz Knox turns that one away. Schroeder with the shot from the point. Calgary cycle down low. They get it out to the far side blue line. Bram makes the pass over to Cudmore. Cudmore shot through traffic. Hits a body in front. Still there. And now Johnston on it for Calgary. Rebecca Johnston with the lone goal in this game. She's stripped of the puck. And now a chance for Lindsay Vine to skate it out for Brampton. Vine hits center ice, dumps it in, and will peel off for a line change. It's going to be important for Brampton to keep those shifts short here. As you mentioned, they have to have a strong period to make sure they're competitive here in this game.
Yeah, it's something that Brampton has struggled with all season long. I know talking to the Brampton staff here as well, the third period seems to be the nemesis, and as a team, you can see why they're on the outside looking in come playoff time, because your third period's where you win and lose the games. You got to have the strength going into that final 20 minutes, and so far they haven't had it this season.
I think the other stat in terms of Brampton this season is they control it off the draw, and they score! Natasha Fryer, a seeing-eye shot, beats Troutman, and Brampton tie this one up a minute 29 into the second period.
And one thing that Brampton has done well this game, resulted in getting that goal there, has been their faceoffs. They have dominated Calgary in the faceoff circle with almost a 10% advantage in their favor there. So puck possession, puck control is a big part of it, especially in that offensive zone there. And that resulted in that goal going in on Camille Troutman.
Camille Troutman, not sure she really saw that shot. There was traffic in front of her, and it certainly didn't seem like much of a threatening shot from Fryer, but it does get by Troutman, and that gives Brampton a response. They tie this game up early in the second period, 1-1. Chance here, Campbell in tight, makes the pass, and Davis unable to corral it. Shot from the point, blocked, Esposito on it. She takes a shot and scores! Brittany Esposito right back, Calgary regained the lead.
Well, kind of a harmless-looking play there at first, and until the puck gets on Brittany Esposito's stick and We know how dangerous she can be, and as of late, this line has been the best line for the Calgary Inferno. They call themselves the class of 2014, as all of them rookies and graduates in 2014, and they have been on fire lately to sneak a cheesy pun in there.
Yeah, the Inferno have certainly been hot as of late, and Brittany Esposito, maybe one of the hottest players on Calgary as of late, make it now 3 goals, 2 assists in this, her last 3 games. So she's really been leading the way offensively, and that line continues to press for more as Esposito and Davis work away for the puck. Seedhouse, good job to get it around the Calgary defender, and now Pierre has to retrieve this inside her own zone. Esposito continues to have a great season for Calgary. That's now 10 goals on the season for Esposito, 24 points. More importantly, it regains their lead. Takeuchi and Sarah Davis drawing assists. Davis continue to have a good rookie season as well for the Inferno. 13 points now on the year with that assist. And as Jeff mentioned, she had a great game last night in that 5-2 victory. Calgary working for more here after answering back. Just 30 seconds after Brampton tied this game up. Thunder charged with icing here early in the second period. You're watching Calgary vs. Brampton on CWHL.ca. Buzzos. Well, I was going to mention before that fury of goals was that Brampton really haven't had success at home, and that's maybe a little surprising. You expect teams to do well on home ice. Brampton's record, just 2-8-1 here at Century Gardens Arena. Rattray brings it across the blue line, tries to make the move around Wong, but well, Wong didn't bite that time. Good stand-up D there. Skirl wraps one in on goal. Troutman with a paddle save. Wong, chance to lead the breakout here. She does. Stretch pass intended for Warren, broken up by Vine, and now Knox comes out of her goal to play it to Mallory Johnston in the far corner. Brings it back near side to Jocelyn LaRocque. Brampton's captain uses the boards to get it out to center ice, but Crom first on that puck for Calgary. The Inferno go far side to Bearsons. Bearsons has Stone with her, trailing, and she tried to get it, but Stone couldn't quite corral it. So here comes Brampton. Scanzano and Jones. Scanzano hustling far side, takes it behind the goal, still working with it on her stick. Scanzano, great puck possession, makes the pass. Friars shot, that one deflected just wide as Mercer was on the doorstep. Scanzano's provided some good energy here this afternoon for Brampton, and she picked up that loose puck. She's looking to get it back as, well, she will scoop it up once again. Scanzano across the blue line. Drops it for Mercer. She's got Jones with her, instead gets it down low to Scanzano. Centers it in front. Jones dumped on the play. Play continues on from her knees. Cudmore does a good job to make the pass out. Bailey Bram holds up, waiting for some support off the bench. She's got Rihanna Curio and Rebecca Johnston. Johnston comes up with it. It was a rolling puck that she corralled and then played it down low into the far corner. Bram stops, tried to spin away. Skurrow comes up with it. And Brampton, Jess Jones get it to center ice, but not much further than that. Rebecca Johnston brings it back in across the blue line. Takes it down low behind the goal. Fryer on her defensively. Johnston checks her points for options. She gets it to the point to Pierre, back to Johnston. Johnston far side boards. Pierre steps in, creates room for Johnston. She takes it, lets the shot go, and knocks with a good save on that one. Rebecca Johnston looking for her second of the game, continues to take a good position in the slot. They can't get the pass to her. Fortino clears it out to center ice. Bailey Bram back in across the blue line, evades the check of Scanzano, then she's held up by Fryer. Good job by Brampton to rub Bram off the puck, and now they've got a chance to clear it out here. Mercer turned it over to Takeuchi, gets it over to Campbell. Campbell nearly run over by Fryer, makes the pass to Esposito. She stick handles, centers it back, intended for Campbell, but puck never quite connected with one of Calgary's explosive rookies. As Jeff mentioned, this rookie line has continued to absolutely be a pain for opposition. So much speed and skill, they're really tough to contain. Long brings this in, makes the pass in front. Three Brampton jerseys there converge, but it's Esposito coming up with it, centers it. Campbell back to the point, Long, her shot off a skate. Calgary continue on it. Esposito gets around one, Seedhouse comes in that time. She does a good job defensively, and then she's met by the check of Esposito. Kirk makes the pass to Seedhouse. Great shift from this line from Brampton defensively for sure. And now they create a great chance. Oh, what a goal! Seedhouse on the tee for Fielding Montgomery. And that's the response Brampton need. They tie this one up at two.
Wow, nice job by Brampton using the two-on-one to make the things happen there and tie this game up here. As we see the replay now, Seedhouse coming across, flipping it up, plays it up perfectly there, and going top corner, no mistake about it.
Really not much chance for Troutman on that one. The quick deflection in that tight. Not too many goaltenders in this league that are going to be able to make that save, and well, that time Troutman victimized by Brampton. We're all tied up at two. Let's see if Calgary can respond as quick as they did the first time. So there's the goal announcement. It's Fielding Montgomery from Ellie Seedhouse. Louise Warren in tight to the goal. That one wide. Shot from the point. Lots of traffic. Hits a Calgary player in front, and Brampton catch a bit of a break as Rattray brings it across the blue line. Rattray gets around Schroeder. Big rebound off the shot. Rattray comes up with it. Good save initially by Troutman, but she let a big rebound out. Mallory Johnston from the point plays it into the far corner. Vine. She tries to protect the puck along the boards. LaRocque keeps it in. Great job at the point by LaRocque. Bookmark that if Brampton can get something going, but they won't be able to this time. Calgary and Louise Warren bring it out. Warren dumps it in at the end of a shift and peels off for a change. So LaRocque makes a quick pass to Scanzano where she turns it over. Right in front of the Calgary bench, they turn it over. Here comes Scanzano. Across the red line, hits the blue line. Oh, she nearly got stood up by Crom coming across the ice. Scanzano just able to avoid that. Well, it's been a fast-paced game in this second period. It's certainly been an exciting one. 2-2, both teams scoring some goals here in this second period. We're still square with 11:30 to go here in the second frame as Berzins creates a bit of space. Can she get to the loose puck? Fortino beats it to her. I thought Berzins was hooked up just a little, but referee's not feeling it warranted a call. So Brampton trying to get a chance of their own now. As they hit the blue line, it was turned over, and here comes Rebecca Johnston. She gets rubbed off the puck by Fryer. No call there. Mallory Johnston. I checked that. That was the goal scorer Fielding Montgomery. She makes the pass to Seedhouse. Ellie Seedhouse does a good job to fight through that check. Centers it, and Jen Kirk unable to get a stick on it. Great second period here from Seedhouse in particular. But here comes Johnston. She's got Curio streaking to the net. Johnston, good D from Simmons, takes the puck away, but still delivers it in front, and Bram unable to get a quality shot. Poked along the near side boards, Bailey Bram. Leaves it for Wong. No, she still has it. Makes the pass in through the slot. Fryer there. Can't clear the zone, though. Esposito spins away and protects it. Makes it back to the point. Down low. Quick pass. Oh, what a save. Huge rebound, and they score. Well, the persistence from Calgary. Great creativity. Knox bailed her team out on the first one, but Rebecca Johnston gets her second of the game.
Well, Rebecca Johnston scored a lot of goals this year. She's had some easy ones thanks to some great passes when she was having Haley Irwin down the center there. I don't know if any of them came easier than this one for her, as the rebound sitting right on the doorstep just had to slide it into the wide open net.
Well, it was really great puck movement by Calgary going cross ice back across the first shot. It was a tremendous save by Liz Knox to even get to it, but well, she had no chance on the rebound, and Johnston made him pay. As you heard it, Esposito and Bram drawing assists, and Here comes Branton right back the other way. O'Hanlon unable to get to that loose puck. Schroeder picks it up. And Schroeder blows a tire there, trying to stop on the dime. Let Calgary extend, or regain the lead, I should say. It's now 3-2 for the Inferno. Team's trading opportunities, and even though Brampton is yet to lead in this game, they've done a good job coming back each time. That'll be the challenge once again here for the Thunder. As Calgary continue to work away at it, Campbell giving a bit of a shot to Stiles. They continue to battle in front of the goal. Too much that time. Campbell's going to be called here. Or will it be Stiles? Like it might going. Be, yeah, it might be both yeah. going. Good point, Jeff.
Yeah, I think that's one of those situations where the ref said, stop it. Okay, you're both going to your room, timeout.
Yeah. So they were willing to go at each other, but the referees felt that they maybe went a little too far. Both Stiles and
Campbell.
Thank you. Can't see her from our vantage point here. Short-term memory issues. Campbell in the box for Calgary. So we'll get some 4-on-4 here with 9:30 remaining in the period. I should mention that out-of-town score between Boston and Montreal. 3-1. The Stars are on the board. Thank you very much. A couple of fans right in front of us had the same thought as me. Let's check the out-of-town scoreboard. Brianna Decker with a couple of points in that game for Boston. What a glove save from Troutman. Not too flashy, but a big save. And it keeps Calgary in the lead.
That's definitely one thing about Camille Troutman is she may not be the flashiest goaltender out there, but she's very poised in her position. She always makes every save look simple.
And you can see on that replay, good positioning and good fundamentals. She makes another good save there. She's making tough shots look very easy just because she plays so sound fundamentally. She's a big reason why Calgary have this 3-2 lead, and 4-on-4, they're working for more offense. Takuchi at the point, her shot, that one's blocked by Scanzano into the near corner. Behind the net, Cunningham first on it. Cunningham shields it on the backhand. Continues to stick handle where she dumps it off. First on it there. Well, it's now Webster with the puck. And that'll give Brampton a chance to clear here. Scanzano makes the pass over to Mallory Johnston. She got around Webster and takes it into the corner where she's stripped of the puck. Warren first on it for the Inferno. Rattray in there as well. Webster. It's going to be the Inferno's Jessica Wong coming up with it. She tries to get around Skrull, but turns it over. Skrull stops, looks for an option. Fortino creeping in from the point. Great D that time. They break up the play as I believe that was Schroeder reading it nicely there for Calgary. Here comes Curio cutting to the net. She's hauled down. Penalty or penalty shot?
That's going to be the question.
The referees.
It's going to be a penalty. No excitement out of that one, but a nice try by Rihanna Curio is. She drove in hard, had the angle, cut in, and Fryers left with no choice but to really haul her down there and kind of took out the left foot, tried to do it sneakily enough to make it look like she just fell down, but the referee was not fooled by that one.
Well, you make a good point there. Fryer.
The unique 4-on-3 power play here.
And that's another good point. You don't see this situation too often, but for the next 26 seconds, we will have 4-on-3 power play time for Calgary. So the Inferno here with 7:57 remaining in the second period, a chance to extend this lead even further potentially. And Scott Reed opting to put some big guns out there. Sarah Davis, Danny Stone leading the way offensively for Calgary, but Brampton win the faceoff and fire it right down the ice. Schroeder will lead the breakout. She makes the pass over to Cudmore. Cudmore tries to gain the zone. They get it in deep, but Leroy quickly dumps that one out. High stick being signaled here, so that will bring a stoppage. And
timed it well.
Yeah, perfectly, because Campbell and Stiles now out of the box.
I don't think that was the intent at all by Tegan Schroeder there, but a nice added benefit as you get your full power play unit out there, get the number one unit out there, try to extend this lead to 4-2 with just over 7 minutes to play.
Well, because of the high stick, the faceoff will come inside Calgary territory, and the Inferno control the puck off the draw. Buck 30 remaining on the power play. They'll lead out the rush as Bailey Bram hits the blue line with speed. She checks her options, drops it to Cunningham. Cunningham tied up by Scurro. Bram in there to help as well, and Bram wins the puck. Curio creeping in. Oh, that pass just out of her reach. Great presence of mind to deliver the pass by Johnson, but the accuracy not quite there.
Yeah, it was a good opportunity there, but sometimes those go by the wayside.
Yeah, unfortunately, because Curio had done a good job sneaking in. Now Johnson drops it for Bram. Still 53 seconds remaining on the Calgary power play, but once again, Brampton efficient on the PK. They clear the zone. Jessica Wong behind her own goal, regroup. Makes the pass to Johnson, who quickly gives it back to Wong. She goes cross ice in front of Calgary's bench. Campbell brings it in. Check that. That's Cunningham who brought it in. Davis makes the pass. Warren spins away from one. Davis there. Campbell coming off the bench now. She gets the puck. Makes maybe one pass too many. Maybe should have shot there as she was in a good position. Cunningham has it at the point. She plays it down low. Warren behind the goal. Live bounce off the end boards, but Campbell does a good job to control it. Sarah Davis loses it to Seedhouse, and that'll do it for the Calgary power play. Seedhouse will hit center ice and then dump that one in. Good job by Brampton, once again shorthanded. Sarah Davis across Brampton's blue line. She's stood up there by Fortino, and it causes a turnover, but as Brampton look for the long stretch pass, they turn it over in turn. Webster, she's got room to skate. She hits the blue line. Kelsey Webster, her shot off the stick of Mallory Johnston, stays in play. Webster picks it up behind the goal. Near side faceoff dot. Top of the circle, lets a shot go. Knox with the save. Big rebound. It's in the far corner where Fielding Montgomery gets it to the blue line and out. Good pressure there and some good offensive chances for Kelsey Webster pinching in from the point.
Yeah, not known for offensive prowess there, but wanted to join the party.
She certainly created some good chances. Not that, like you said, you'll see her do it too often, but when she does, well, sometimes it works out. As that time it works out for Calgary. Tegan Schroeder extends their lead. It's now 4-2.
And Tegan Schroeder, one of the things that she does best as a defenseman is that quick release shot, and got the chance off the loose puck there. Stone and Crom kind of went for it and sniped it low glove side on Liz Knox there, making a 4-2 goal lead.
Well, I think Danny Stone will probably end up drawing an assist on that one.
I believe she would, and I'm not sure if Crom did touch that as well on the third one. But I know that definitely came out of the sticks of Danny Stone for that, sure.
And for Stone, well, it's good to see her tallying some points after a tremendous season last year. The production hasn't quite been there, but frankly, Calgary hasn't needed her to produce the same way she did last season, so it adds a little bit more depth in their lineup. And here comes the Calgary goal announcement. No question about it, Schroeder gets the goal. Well, there you go. Crom does indeed draw the assist along with Stone, so that line continues to do well. Pierian off the point. They jam away at it as Bram has it now. Calgary looking to extend the lead even further here, really pouring it on with 4:20 to go in the period. Curio, she's bumped into the boards by Vine. She was pinned there for a moment. No call. Play continues on. Johnson down low to Bram. Bram, stick handles, tried to force a pass. That one was blocked, but it ends up on the stick of Johnson. Johnson continues to hold it, makes the pass to Cucci. Far side over to Curio. Curio, sharp angle. Oh, what a save by Knox. Big rebound, though. Johnson, she centers it right in on goal, and Knox, with the pad down, able to freeze it for the faceoff.
Well, great pressure there by the top line, by the Inferno. Commenting about Danny Stone. She has come on as of late, of course, getting the goal in the Boston series there last week, and would be nice to see her regain her scoring form from last year going to Clarkson Cup.
Absolutely. That would certainly be a bonus for Calgary heading to the Clarkson Cup to get Danny Stone producing the way she was last season. And well, again, we talk about the offense that Calgary's been able to generate, I guess in part you know, it hasn't hurt them too much, the drop-off, just because other players have really stepped up.
Yeah, no, she's found herself playing in a bottom six forward role, mm-hmm. but she's done a good job of that, providing that little bit of offense when she can. So it definitely helps having that depth on a team, especially when you go up against the Bostons in Montreal, who really know how to win games.
Yeah, that's a good point. And it's an unofficial final between Boston and Montreal. Unofficially 3-1 the final score. So that would mean Boston clinch first, and that would mean Calgary, well, they'll finish second, and they'll be playing Montreal in the Clarkson Cup.
Yeah, Boston had first clinched with the win last night, as they would have won any tie-breaking scenario right. between us and them in Montreal. But the nice thing now is that does give Calgary second place for
yes.
us, and it also means that Rebecca Johnson will be your Angela James Bowl winner,
great
as well
point.
As the league scoring champion.
Yep, that's a really great point. Brandon Decker gave her a bit of a run there late with 2 points in that 3-1 victory for Boston. But yeah, you're absolutely right. The Angela James Bowl winner this year will be Rebecca Johnston for the outstanding season she has had with the Calgary Inferno. We've still got 2:18 left here in the second period. Calgary has built a 4-2 lead here in the second period, and they continue to press for more. Knocks out of her goal, plays it off the glass to the blue line, but Webster holds it in at the point. Fortino, she's dumped there by a couple of players. Play goes on. And I think she's had a pretty good rookie season in the CWHL, but no question, Jeff, this Brampton team, they're going to be disappointed they couldn't get to the Clarkson Cup. They had an opportunity down the stretch, but losing four straight, it essentially cost them that playoff berth.
Well, it definitely was hard when they beat Toronto here, but they couldn't win it in regulation, giving Toronto that one extra point, and it really took the control out of Brampton's hands for being able to get into the playoffs. Would have had to beat a couple of really good teams to get in there, and Boston right now has been anything but beatable. So
yeah, really. Digit Murphy, is that team firing on all cylinders? Dangerous team heading into the playoffs. It's going to be a great Clarkson Cup. Make sure you come out to Markham. Get your tickets on CWHL.ca. And you know what? We'll be webcasting a few of those games as well. We'll have the Wednesday games. And we'll see how hospitable Sportsnet will be in terms of allowing us to do more. But for sure, we'll bring you the Wednesday games as we get set for the 2015 Clarkson Cup. Last minute of play here in the second period. It's Calgary 4, Brampton 2. The Inferno have the puck. Rebecca Johnston across the blue line. Johnston with 40 seconds left on the clock centers it. Danger still there. There's a play down low. Trying to bring it in front was Bram, but she lost the puck as she tried to cut to the net, and now Brampton get it out to center ice. Rattray dumps it in, peels off for a change. 25 seconds remaining in the period here between the Calgary Inferno and the Brampton Thunder. Curio makes the pass over to Johnston. She's got space, hits it. Still 15 seconds left, puts it in on goal, and Knox, not taking any chances, will hold that one for the draw.
It's been a solid period by the Calgary Inferno. Every time that Brampton would get a goal, they were quick to answer back and put the lead back on their side of things there. So they made it very tough for Brampton to get back into this game, and they're going to have their work cut out for them in the third period.
Just 10 seconds remaining in the period. There's a shot from distance. Knox with the save. Big rebound. Still 5 seconds here. Calgary pressing late. Brampton clear it. That'll just about do it. I think they're just going to call the period here. So after 40 minutes of play, the Calgary Inferno, as Jeff mentioned, well, they respond when Brampton responds, and it's 4-2. A very entertaining game. Still a very tight game, but Jeff, I think we saw Calgary step it up a little bit in that second period.
Yeah, they definitely, as I said, kind of took the bull by the horns there and made sure that any time that Brampton got any type of momentum, they would shut them down. They would come back to it. And, I mean, it really showed, as I've got the shots 11-4 for Calgary in that period there, as they tried to really eliminate any chances that Brampton had. Brampton, of course, still getting the 2 goals there. So 2 goals on 4 shots is a line that, you know, Camille Troutman will not be happy with. But when she looks up at the scoreboard, she'll have a big smile on her face for that, at least.
Well, I'm pretty sure Susan Schroeder's got a big smile on her face. Watching him play at Del Carmen, Mexico, Hashtag go Inferno. Nice goal for Tegan Schroeder. So proud relative there tweeting in. And of course, we want to hear from you. You can tweet us at CWHL_insider, at Bro Behind the Mic. And Jeff, throw your handle out there one more time.
WWOJEFF.
After 40 minutes of play, it's the Calgary Inferno with a 4-2 lead over the Brampton Thunder. You're watching live on SSNCanada.ca and CWHL.ca.
If you think texting in the middle of a game is a bad idea, what about texting while driving? Don't even think about it.
Drive now, text later, live longer. A message from Insurance Bureau of Canada and the Canadian Women's Hockey League.
I've been in the league for 2 years now, and I've seen such a tremendous growth from the beginning, and I know that this can go so much further. So come watch this hockey. It's something that you're not going to see elsewhere other than the Olympics. And at the end of the day, those girls have to be in a league, and they play in the CWHL.
Fines. Just scores!
We live at a time when women are busy breaking barriers and building skills at an unprecedented rate. But the women of the CWHL are building skills faster and better than any other sports group in the world.
The accolades, and here we have a chance now to tie it up. Scores! Right there! Emmanuel Play!
The Canadian Women's Hockey League, the CWHL, doesn't just provide top-level hockey. It provides a place for those top athletes to go for all those years between those international competitions where they can continue to compete at the top level.
Having the opportunity to put a goal in and experience kind of a little bit of what the Flames experienced.
Oh, that got Cardell in the hand. Shot scores! Upstairs and over the shoulder.
I think it was that first time in my career, at least, that I realized it's going somewhere, and we're really solidifying the notion that this is a league worth following. It's a league worth growing, and the talent and everything that surrounds that is here.
Patch now. Patch leaves it for number 17. Shot scores!
You know, we're trying to better the league and try to, you know, grow it. And hopefully we can inspire a couple of young girls to, you know, play NCAA hockey or national level hockey and pave the way. You know, we're trying to pave the way for them. So hopefully we inspired a couple of them to pursue their dreams of becoming a great hockey player.
Award trophy, but she comes down. Scores! Natalie Spooner! Toronto goes to the Clarkson Cup Final and faces Digit Murphy's Boston Blaze!
Yeah.
your puck. We just have to wait till the attendants are clear of the ice. Okay, are we ready in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Chuck-a-puck! Again, ladies and gentlemen, don't forget that on Saturday, March 14th at 7 p.m. at the Powerade Center, the Brampton Thunder will be playing a charity game against the NHL alumni. Come out and cheer on your favorite Thunder players and some former NHL greats. Tickets are available at the admissions table, and they are $10 today and will be $15 at the gate on March 14th. So pick up your tickets at the for the Brampton Thunder versus the NHL alumni on Saturday, March 14th, 7 p.m. at the Powerade Center.
Well, folks, welcome back to the Century Gardens Arena in Brampton, Ontario. 20 minutes remaining in this contest, and just 20 minutes remaining in the regular season for the Brampton Thunder. Calgary, they've still got a little more hockey to play. That'll start up this week in Markham
And Jeff, right now Calgary, I think they just want to finish this game strong but also healthy. You really can't afford to pick up any injuries at this point.
Yeah, most definitely. You know, that's been a concern for the Inferno as of late, as injuries have impacted the team over the last stretch of the season. None so more than kind of surmounted in the three-game series against the Montreal Stars in Montreal the weekend after the national camp, where we had eight players participating in that, and that may have been the difference, 4 points that we lost in that series, that could have been a big difference of us getting a chance at first place here. So injuries we know well, and hopefully we've had our share of them for the season. We can put them behind us now and focus on winning some hockey games.
Well, that's certainly going to be the focus for Calgary here in the final 20 minutes. And, of course, in a few days from now when the Clarkson Cup gets going, Calgary with a 4-2 lead here in the third period. You're watching live on CWHL.ca and SSNCanada.ca. My name's Nico Cardarelli, providing you with play-by-play coverage. Jeff Stevenson joining me up here for color commentary. And we want to thank Jeff very much, because we started this broadcast shorthanded, and well, he just kind of volunteered his services sitting below us in the stands. So, Jeff, once again, thank you so much for jumping up here.
Oh, my pleasure. It's always fun to get in on these broadcasts and call a game from up here.
And we are more than happy to have you. I'll have to come out to Calgary at some point, and maybe you guys can return the favor. Let me jump on a broadcast. But it seems like a great building where you guys play, too. And, you know, as Calgary and Rihanna Curry will bring the puck in here, I'm curious, what's the take in terms of the popularity of the team growing within Calgary? Are you guys seeing more of a fan base starting to follow you at this point?
Oh, we definitely have. I mean, this year has been...
Oh! Freak play ends up behind Troutman. Brampton make it 4-3 on a very unlucky bounce for Calgary.
I think that was Scanzano that threw the puck at the net, and... Camille Troutman has not been super busy today, and hasn't had the best of luck with a couple of those goals there, as she has been beat three times now on, I think, only about 14 shots about now in the game. So not the game that Camille Troutman wants to have going into the Clarkson Cup final, where most likely you're going to have to use both goalies in there. Especially if you end up in a situation where you play four games in 4 nights.
Sure.
It's a lot of juggling around, and I know Coach Reed has been debating what his goaltending plan is going to be going into the playoffs, because do you ride your starter goalie in the first game hoping that you win, and what happens if you lose it? Now you got to go back to the starter, and all sorts of scenarios that play out there. So it'll be interesting to see what all the teams end up doing in net for the Clarkson Cup.
Yeah, it's a really good point there, Jeff. I mean, Catherine Heron gets the start today for Montreal in that loss to Boston as Sarah Davis brings it in. Nice drop pass. Oh, they try connect on a tic-tac-toe play, but didn't quite work out. Campbell couldn't find her teammate on the last pass. But yeah, with Heron getting the start for Montreal and Troutman getting the start here for Calgary, certainly seems like, as Jess Jones gets credit for the Brampton goal, it certainly seems like the coaches understand the point you're making and the importance of having both goaltenders playing well going into the Clarkson Cup.
Yeah, well, don't tell Scott that I said this, but he's a smart guy and knows what he's doing back there. So have faith that he'll make the right decision when it comes down to it and can help lead this team to their first Clarkson Cup championship.
That's certainly going to be the intent for Calgary in the Clarkson Cup this year. They're not just there to participate, as maybe the feeling was last year. They're there to be a threat to win the Cup. And the way they're playing all regular season and here this afternoon, they're certainly a threat, as Warren unable to corral that loose puck.
Yeah, you hit the nail right on the head there last year. I mean, no one wants to say they're just there to join the party, but... Really, that was Calgary's goal, was to make the playoffs, make the Clarkson Cup, and they did that. And once they got there, they were outmatched. I mean, they were the only team that didn't have an Olympic player come back and join them. But beside the point, they were outmatched and outplayed and just couldn't get anything going. This year, it's Cup or bust.
Seedhouse with a shot. Big rebound as Troutman made the initial save. And here comes Calgary back the other way. Cup or bust, that's definitely the feeling for the Inferno as they look to extend the lead. It's 4-2. They're banging away for more. Takuchi's shot saved by Knox. Kept in. Good job there by Haig as she got it down low, but it ends up on the stick of Simmons, and it'll give Brampton a chance to skate it out across center ice. Lindsay Vine dumps it in with the backhand, and Troutman out of her net leaves it for Takuchi. She spins away from the check before making the pass to Pieri. And Stone stopped. She can't get up the near side board, so Calgary will try the breakout along the far side. This time, well, the bit of bad luck keeps the puck in the zone. Rattre has it. Rattre drops it, intended for Vine, but she's beat to that loose puck. Rattre centers again. Calgary get it to the line, but not out. Mallory Johnson shot blocked by Crom, and Crom off to the races here, one-on-one against Larocque. Larocque tries to keep her to the outside, and Crom shot away from goal. No threat that time.
Yeah, good play by Jocelyn Larocque, player that the Calgary Inferno, some of them that have been around for a few years, are very familiar with, having played with the Inferno before.
And of course, Larocque, part of the off-season retooling that Calgary did, sending Larocque to Brampton in return, Bailey Bram with the Calgary Inferno.
And I think that's a trade that's definitely worked out well for both teams, as Bailey's added another depth of experience and offensive ability up there. She hasn't had the numbers to go with it, but she's certainly had the chances, and she has a habit of playing her best hockey when the spotlight's on her, so expect good things from her coming in the Clarkson Cup as well.
Yeah, she's certainly going to be a player to watch down the Clarkson Cup, and here she's a player to watch. Tries to get around her Olympic teammate Laura Fortino, but Fortino did a good job to rub Bram off the puck temporarily. Bram has it once again. Down low behind the goal, centering, intended for Curio, but that one's knocked away, and Fortino will lead the rush here for Brampton. She's across the blue line, red line, and now the blue line, but she got held up. Takes it into the zone. She's got Jones with her. Tries to feed it over, but by the time she did, Calgary was able to get sticks on it, and that took away any potential chance. Jones first to that puck in the corner, ends up behind the net where Webster gets it, plays it back into the far corner. Campbell, she gives it away to Kirk. Kirk makes the pass to Seedhouse. She's along the far side hash marks. Seedhouse stops, centers it to Kirk. That one broken up temporarily. Campbell, good job back checking, and Kirk with a good second effort keeps the puck in the zone. Seedhouse battling with Webster. Kirk in there as well. So is Sarah Davis. That's going to be Kirk who comes up with the puck. Gets it to Seedhouse. She tees one up. That one's blocked by Davis. And here comes Calgary in transition. Esposito. She's got Campbell with her. Oh, great play by Stiles to break that up, because Campbell wanted to tee up a one-timer. Stiles, after making the interception, brings it in. Her centering pass wide of the goal as she was trying to connect with O'Hanlon. Pace starting to pick up again here in the third after it was a bit of a slow start to the period. Good chance for Campbell, but Larocque once again playing tough D, and then Knox holds on to that one.
And going back to what we were talking about right before that Brampton goal there, you're asking about the growth of fan base in Calgary, and that's something that we're really happy about, with the progress we've made in Calgary and the steps forward we have made there. As their last weekend show, we had pretty much standing room only in our arena area where we played in about a 270 seat facility on that side, mm-hmm. and hoping that next year we'll be able to move into the bigger rink just down the hall, which of course is Team Canada's right. home rink there, where you can fit about 3,500 people into it.
Well, that's
and
fantastic.
Have a lot of room to grow the fan base in a building like that, in a
absolutely.
Rink like that.
Well, that's absolutely tremendous. And here's a great chance for Calgary in tight, but Knox gets the paddle down to shut the door, and that's a big save for Brampton, keeping this at a one-goal game.
Yeah. And of course, the facilities there that we play in Winsport
yep.
are second to none. I mean, they take care of us great there. The girls have their own locker room, their own space to really develop in, and it showed with a consistent product on the ice this year.
And I think we should talk about a couple of events that the Calgary Inferno hosted pretty recently. You guys did some great promotion around us. There's a shot right on Knox, and after juggling it, she's able to snag it with her trapper. One of them was around the Heart and Stroke Foundation. Jackie Pieri, a big part of that. And then the other one, if I recall, is around mental health awareness.
Yes, the youth mental health game, and that one was one that was really championed by Jessica Campbell. It's an issue that's very close to her heart, as she's had, I believe, a roommate back in college take her own life due to issues there. So it's something that she seeked out the opportunity when she got to Calgary, struck up a relationship with the Sheldon Kennedy Child Advocacy Center, and one thing led to another, and we were happy as an organization to get behind that and get on board with that. And it was a really good game on the Saturday. It was a good game on the ice that went to a shootout, and unfortunately, Jessica had the opportunity to be the hero on her own night, but Genevieve Lacasse spoiled the party with a big save on her.
Well, it's great to hear that it was well received by the fan base and the community, and a successful couple of nights by the Calgary Inferno.
And the Heart and Stroke Foundation, yeah. We were able to raise $2,500 as well on the event during the game day and with online donations. So
that's,
I want to
thank tremendous.
Everyone that contributed to that as well. Made it a big, huge success.
Fortino with a good chance, but Troutman turns her away, and here's a two-on-one. Stone, she's got Cudmore with her. Makes the pass, and the shot just wide of the cage. Great chances at both ends of the ice right now, but Calgary unable to increase that lead, try regain that two-goal lead they had coming into this period. But, Jeff, really great to hear that both of those events very successful and great initiatives for the Calgary Inferno to get behind and associated with.
Well, thank you very much. It was our pleasure doing it. Something we definitely look forward to growing on and improving in next season as well.
I think that's something the league does really well additionally in terms of getting behind different initiatives, fundraising events, stuff along that nature. Of course, the Pink at the Rink games, so many fantastic events by all five CWHL teams, and there's a shot turned away by Knox. So once again, kudos to everyone involved with those efforts. Stiles digs that puck out, gets it to center ice with 11:15 remaining in the third period. Webster makes the pass to Bram. She gets it to Curio. Curio, top of the circle, makes the pass intended for Johnston, but just out of her reach. Long coming off the bench. Johnston, nice job to hold it in at the blue line. Long, sharp shot, and Knox makes the save. No rebound that time because Sarah Davis was right there on the doorstep.
Wouldn't that have been a nice feather in the cap for Rebecca Johnston to get a hat trick on the day that you clinched the scoring championship in the CWHL, of course. First player from Calgary to have that honor as well, so we're very proud of her as well.
Absolutely, and further to that point, Trevor Down tweeting us, first player in more than five seasons not to wear a Montreal jersey to win that distinction. So again, fantastic individual accolade there for Rebecca Johnston, and no question the Calgary Inferno very proud of her season.
And the only question I have with it is how many more points would she have had if Haley Irwin had been healthy for the last part of this season as well.
Yeah, that's a good point. Irwin's been out of action down the stretch, and well, the Inferno would love to have her back come Clarkson Cup time, but we'll see if she's able to rejoin the team. They continue to bang away. Davis with a good chance there, but once again, Knox, so good at covering that lower portion of the net, makes a save.
I can say that she definitely has been getting closer to, and it will be kind of probably a tournament time decision whether she is able to go or not. And hopefully she can, because it definitely adds another depth to this team that you really miss with having a player of her skill and talent and experience out of the lineup.
Cunningham chips it forward for Calgary, and Seedhouse first on it for Brampton. Can't clear the zone. Centering in front. Good stick handling. Backhanded shot by Warren, and Knox has to make a couple of good saves in tight.
And good pressure by Calgary here as we turn our attention back to the game for the final 10 minutes here. We've still got a 4-3 hockey game here, and a lot could happen. I mean, we all know the standings are set now, so playoff implications are out of this game, but there's a lot of pride on the line. Brampton, of course, would like to beat Calgary. They haven't been able to do so in 10 games. Of course, the last time that Brampton did win was back in this building at the start of last season, which was a shootout win. So Brampton would like to go back to that type of play against the Calgary Inferno.
Calgary's had Brampton's number, as Jeff just mentioned, and with that 5-2 win last night and a 4-3 lead right now, Brampton in tough once again against Calgary. As Fryer digs it out, Fortino there as well. Fryer hauled down, no call. Play continues on. Cunningham, sharp angle shot, bounces off a couple players and then through the crease wide of the goal. Great backhanded opportunity that time from Jess Wong, but she's turned away by Liz Knox. It's been a busy second and third period for Liz Knox. She's had to make a number of quality saves. Vine picks up that loose puck. tries to get the pass over to Scanzano, ends up reaching her. Troutman got her stick caught up in the far side mesh. She just had to abandon it there for a minute, and now she's able to go back to it. Must have a pretty big knob there on the stick to get it caught in the mesh.
Oh,
that time they catch Liz Knox. Erica Kram makes it 5-3.
That was a couple things you don't see very often in the season is the stick going behind the net there, and Erica Kram, her third goal of the season there. So Erica Kram, of course, one of the heart and soul of the Calgary Inferno there, not known for putting the puck in the back of the net, but she has had a couple goals, and this one here, nice example of just getting the shot on net there and good things happen.
Yeah, she was in the right place at the right time, and it was a shot along the ice that ends up beating Liz Knox. And for Erica Kram, as Jeff just mentioned, her third of the season, but for Calgary, regains that two-goal lead. Oh, Johnson with a little bit of flash and dash. She's working on the hat trick to get that done. Curiel, near side boards, puts it down low. Bailey Bram tried to get it back to Curiel. Pierre's shot from the point through traffic, and Knox able to track that one down.
And if you're watching at home, as I know you are if you're listening to us, don't expect Calgary to loosen up here at all, because they are going to keep the pressure going. They're going to keep trying to do the things that they want to build on to going against Montreal in a few days' time at the Clarkson Cup, as we've get the clock started out as it was running after that stoppage of play there.
So we'll have a short delay to get the clock reset here, and as Jeff just alluded to, in a couple days it will be Calgary taking on Montreal in the Clarkson Cup, and that means it'll be Boston-Toronto in the other matchup. So a couple of great rivalries, and you can catch all that action streaming, as the CWHL tweeted out not too long ago. You can get the streaming pack, but if you're in the GTA, come on out to Markham. Make sure you get down to the Centennial Arena. Tickets still available. For all ticket information, check out CWHL.ca. Bailey Brandt makes the pass over to Rihanna Curio. She hits the blue line, takes it down low. Mallory Johnston forces her into the corner, but now Bram comes up with it behind the goal. Good sweeping poke check that time by Knox. Knocked it away momentarily, but Calgary still pressing. Pinching in there was Rebecca Johnston. She continues to stick handle, puts it behind the goal to Bram, centers it out front. What a save by Knox. Point blank one-timer, and she turns it away. Curiel with a great chance there.
There's the Fort Knox we know.
Yes. Fort Knox in full defense mode on that one. Oh, there she turns it over, though, to Campbell. Fortino starts it up behind her own goal. Brampton trailing by two with 7:33 remaining in the third period. Fortino trying one of these coast-to-coast plays. Let's a shot go, but that one's blocked by Schroeder. Schroeder having quite the game here for Calgary, coming up with a goal and a number of big defensive plays. Certainly one of the more effective players out there for Calgary this afternoon. Good job by the undersized Jenny Kirk to tie up Cudmore along the end boards. Esposito, she's stripped of the puck by Seedhouse. Bouncing puck through the slot, and well, Calgary unable to clear the zone. Fortino steps in from the point. Backhands that one just over top the goal. Great shot there from Fortino on the backhand.
And I know you talked earlier about the retooling of Brampton, but the one thing that you got to look, and you got a good solid core in Brampton with, is the backhand side of things. Their goaltending and their defense, they got a lot to rebuild around there. It actually reminds me a lot of what Calgary was like for the last couple seasons, where they didn't have the offensive ability, but they had very strong players on the back end.
There's a shot from the blue line from Calgary off Kelsey Webster's stick, and that's a really good comparison there, Jeff. I think you're right. If Brampton, you know, going into the draft, going into the summer, are able to make a couple of moves to acquire some skilled offensive players, some pure goal scorers, you could really see this team take a jump up in the standings, because you're right. Defensively, they've really made some good strides this season compared to where they were last year. Here comes Calgary in on a chance. Great passing, and the shot off of Cunningham's stick goes just wide of the goal. Mercer back the other way for Brampton. Gets around Wong, plays it down low to the corner, but Mercer still able to come up with it. Wraparound chance stopped. Simmons, her shot from the point, and No chance to beat Troutman on that one. She just squeezes it for the faceoff.
And now that we know those Clarkson Cup matchups, it is safe to say the time of the game there. So Boston-Toronto, the first game that kicks it off at 11 a.m. Eastern time, 9 o'clock back out in Calgary. And then the Inferno play their first game, 3:30 p.m. Eastern time, against the Montreal Stars, 1:30 out Mountain time. And those games, of course, are streamed live on the SSN network.
And, of course, you can catch it all on CWHL.ca as Brampton had that Gold Mouse scramble turned away. Here comes Danny Stone for the Inferno. Stone shields it on the backhand into the corner. She gets some support there from Crom, who plays it back to the point, but it was picked off by Jones. And here comes Brampton's best line of the afternoon. Scanzano and Jones have been two of their best players, but, well, Scanzano's now going to peel off for a line change at the end of that shift. Stone back the other way for Calgary, tries to get around LaRocque. LaRocque takes her into the corner. Good physical play there from Jocelyn LaRocque. Brampton still pinned within their own zone. LaRocque gets the pass from Johnston, make a quick pass over to Jones. She gains center ice and dumps it right in on Troutman, who leaves it for a defender. Schroeder evades one check but not the second. Skuro comes up with it, centers right in front. Oh, big save, big rebound. The puck was sitting there in the blue paint, but nice for Brampton, no one there.
Nice stick by Cudmore to poke that out of the danger zone.
Yeah, really good job by Cudmore to be there defensively, providing some support. You could definitely call Kenny Loggins. That one was certainly in the danger zone, but as Jeff mentioned, Cudmore comes to her goaltender's aid defensively. Icing the call here against Brampton. 4:13 remaining in the period, and just 4:13 remaining in Brampton season.
And from the danger zone to the thunder zone.
We got to get you up here more often, man. You're on fire.
You're the only one that appreciates my cheesy puns. Marshall hates them. I can hear him rolling his eyes already, and he's probably not even able to watch this one. But I know that he's probably just sitting there and be like, something's wrong. Something's going on.
Once again, Jeff Stevenson up here doing color commentary today. We want to thank him so much for joining us on the fly. My name's Nico Cardarelli. You can connect with the CWHL on Twitter through social media at CWHL_insider. Of course, both these teams with their respective accounts as well, at Inferno CWHL and at Brampton CWHL. Jeff, go ahead, throw your Twitter handle out there.
It's at WWO Jeff, of course. You can also just tweet at the Inferno one, as I manage that one for the team as well. So throw the support towards the team. I don't need it.
There you go. So hit him up on Twitter, at Inferno CWHL. Is here, Brittany Esposito brings it in. Nice move. Good shot. But Fortino able to get a stick on that shot. Big defensive play by Fortino to stay with Esposito, because Esposito was starting to dangle through the zone there.
Sometimes it's all you can do. And she did play it well. Just stayed with her. And then right when the shot was coming, get the stick in the way and throw it off her plan. Sometimes it's a smarter defensive play than trying to take the puck off someone.
Yep, good point. Just be there defensively, and I'm sure Liz Knox appreciates that effort from Laura Fortino. As we're inside the final 3 minutes of the third period, long outlet pass intended for Cunningham out of her reach, and Knox wisely comes out of the net to get that puck.
Well, surprise, surprise, Fortino with a stick again, saving that breakaway chance.
Fortino still out there for Brampton, but it's Warren with a backhander that goes over top the goal. She was going high blocker side, but couldn't quite find the net. Scanzano and Fortino lead the rush here for Brampton. Great pass over to Fortino, but she couldn't quite get enough on the shot, as a couple of Calgary defenders there closing in on her. But Scanzano and Fortino continue to be a positive momentum factor for Brampton.
Yeah, I'm definitely there, and they are the building pieces I think you look around, build around the future with this team. You always have a mindset on what can we do to get stronger, what can we do to get better, no matter if you're in first place or you're in fifth place. And you also look at the players that you have that are kind of your untouchables that you don't want to give up no matter what. And for Brampton, I think those are two of the players that have to be at the top of that list of players that you don't want to get rid of or lose.
Yeah, I would think you're right on with that one. Scanzano's shot right off the point, or off the draw, is blocked. It's at the point and tipped into the far corner. Scanzano comes up with it. Stiles heading into the slot. They couldn't deliver the pass to her, and Calgary clear the zone with 2:05 left in the third period. Stone. Nice job by Crom to get back out across the zone and avoid an offside, and then she was able to get the puck in further. So some good work late here by Calgary. Erica Crom digging away at it. Berzin's in there as well, and with Simmons tying it up against the boards, that'll bring a stoppage in play.
And just under 2 minutes left in the Brampton Thunder season here. Of course, they do have a charity game coming up here, I believe, too, at the end of the month here.
Yeah, it's they just announced it, and you can check out their Twitter account for full details. I actually retweeted it as well. But it's a charity game that's being hosted at the Powerade Center. It's going to be taking place, the Brampton Thunder, against the NHL alumni. So that should be quite the game, should be quite the evening. And, of course, you can get your tickets for that one. Just check out the Brampton Thunder Twitter site for all the details, of course, at Brampton CWHL. Brampton pressing for a late one there, but it's turned over, and here comes Cunningham up the ice. She makes the pass to Brand just offside. I'll bring a stoppage with a buck 20 left in play.
I wonder if Scanzano will be the tallest player on the ice for that game, too.
There's a chance. Yeah, depending on who's on that NHL alumni team, yeah, she might be. Of course, you can get your tickets for that one. A great night in support of a great cause as well. Check it out at Brampton CWHL on Twitter. 1:10 remaining in the third period. Can Brampton answer late, trailing by two? Jenny Kirk battling for the puck. O'Hanlon there as well. It's picked up by the Inferno, and they'll clear the zone here. Rihanna Curio across center ice. She's got Wong trailing with her, and Bram there as well, but Curio still holds it. Centering, far side intended for Webster, and she has to kick it down low behind the goal. Bram kicks it to her own stick, where she's rubbed off the puck by the rock. Brampton cleared out to center ice. Well.
And you talk about injury prevention. That was Rebecca Johnson's line, and despite the two goals,
she was not out
Patrick,
there.
She was not out there.
Yep.
So taking no chances when it comes to your best player is a great chance there by Jessica Campbell.
And
a nicer save.
Yeah, great save by Liz Knox to turn her away as Campbell teed that one up. That's a good point there, Jeff, that Scott Reed is playing it smart now. He doesn't want to risk key pieces getting hurt down the stretch. And with just seconds left here in this one, Calgary Inferno finished the CWHL regular season with 15 wins, good for 33 points on the year, and they'll be going to the Clarkson Cup. Brampton, well, not quite as successful this season, but those girls should keep their head high. They played very strong all year long. They should be proud of their performance, and well, they just are going to miss out once again on the playoffs.
Yeah, it's too bad that not everyone gets to play in the playoffs, but they wouldn't be called the playoffs if everyone got to come play. So someone's got to miss out to the dance, and unfortunately it's Brampton for the second year in a row. They did have their chance to get there. They had a pretty good start to the season. The opportunity was there with Toronto's struggles, and eventually Toronto just was able to do that little bit extra to get in there. And you know what, their prize for getting in there is to play the Boston Blades in the first matchup, which is a team that we look forward to playing against, but hopefully it'll be different circumstances there, and a winner-take-all game that'll be on March 7th at 2 p.m. Eastern time, broadcast on Sportsnet, and that, of course, would be the Clarkson Cup final, which is what we're looking towards, but you can't look past the team that you got to play, and the last time we played Montreal in a three-game series, they came away with a 2-1 win in that one. So it's a team that can definitely beat us, and I got to give credit to where credit's due. Any team can beat any team in the CWHL on any given night, regardless what the stats say or the streaks say.
Yeah, no, that's a good point, Jeff. As the teams get lined up here for the Three Stars presentation, and we should give Brampton some credit. You know, they had a tough stretch in the middle of the season, and after that rough weekend series against Boston where they kind of had the doors blown off, they opted for the coaching change. Christy Alcorn, I think, did a really tremendous job taking over the team midway through the season. They responded initially, but unfortunately down the stretch they just weren't able to get it done. But I think they should still be very proud of this season.
They definitely should be. I mean, it's tough to win in a professional league, and it's tough to win when you're playing against the best players in the world, and that's what we have in the CWHL is the absolute best players in the world. When you look at what Brianna Decker's done in Boston, it's insane to see a player come into the league and have that type of success instantly. It shows what type of special player that she is, that she can come in and get into a scoring race after, I believe, 12 games. Playing half a season, it's unheard of. And it's not something that's going to happen very often, if ever, again.
Yeah, that's a really good point. Brianna Decker, certainly an impact player with the Boston Blades. The third star of the game was Jen Kirk. Second star of the game was Danny Stone. And great choice here. Angela James Bowl winner, Rebecca Johnston, your first star of today's game.
Yeah, and it's something that when we told her between the periods that she had won, the game was over in Boston. She was like, okay, nice. It's the team accolade she's after. It's a nice thing. It's a nice notch on the hat and something to put on the resume. But at the end of the day, when you've won two gold medals, you really only look one way, and that's you're looking in the direction of where the wins are.
Yep, that's a great point. And as Brampton salutes the home crowd in this, their final game of the regular season, the Calgary Inferno have a couple days off, and then they'll start their Clarkson Cup run. Jeff, I want to thank you so much again for taking the time to join us up here. We really appreciate you doing this.
It's my pleasure. It's fun to stand beside you and call a game with you here. It's something we haven't had a chance to do despite being involved in the league for the last couple of years here. So it was definitely fun and something hopefully we can do another time.
Absolutely. Happy to have you up here anytime. That's Jeff Stevenson. My name's Nico Cardarelli, Steve Mitchell, and our tremendous crew. Thank you so much for tuning into today's game. The final score, once again, Calgary 5, Brampton 3. Thanks for tuning in. Have a good night. Thank you.